the detail of the area design. And then, I will talk about some inside details of the gradient vector, the direction of the gradient vector, and why the gradient vector, the gradient design method actually works. So I will explain that in a bit detail. Then we will, first agenda item is, the very first agenda item is understanding the gradient descent in a little detail. Okay. The second agenda item is, once we are clear that this is the gradient descent and we know that it will work and how it works, we don't teach anything about gradient descent, then we will apply the gradient descent on the logistic regression model. Okay? And that's the second agenda item. And if you get time, we will see a pseudo code of logistic regression right down here, and then I will show you the exact code in MATLAB that I already written, and if that photo folder we are uploading here, that is there in my system. And I will class it you for your folder to come that the value of the cost of the document. Get it? So the very first thing is, what is gradient descent again? When cross pictures should stay at level, there are opinions to some people and they are asking, hey, is he actually the gradient descent? How do you do it and stuff? So I will give you the
result. Is it the normal light pocket?
Okay. First of all, let me tell you what do we mean by gradient vector. A little basic. Okay. And then I will tell you something about that you have already learned in multiple vector calculus. Directional derivative. Remember directional derivative? You have done this in multi-variable calculus course. Direction, the derivative in some direction. That is direction derivative. And then I will prove. So first of all, I will tell you what do we mean by a derivative if your number of variables are more than two, which means your partial derivative with respect to any variable. See? Then I will tell you, if I want to compute the rate of change in a particular direction, how to compute that. So for example, I'm sitting on a surface at some point, okay? But just for simplicity of visualization, assume that there are only two variables, W0 and W1, okay? Two variables. For every W0 and W1 choice, there's a height of the function, okay? And I'm sitting somewhere. Okay. Now, in which direction, the rate of change is fastest. What do we mean by fastest? Fastest means with respect to the step you have chosen. So derivative mein hota kya, you take a step and you calculate with respect to that step how much change has happened in the output of the function. So you move in the input space a little and see how much you have moved in the output space. Make sense? And that ratio is known as derivative. Yes or no? Now, if you are sitting at some point, you can take a step in any direction. Yes? And with respect to the amount of the step you have chosen, what change occurred in the function? Make sense? So the change in the output divided by or the ratio of the change of the output with the change in the input, that actually tells you the derivative of the rate of change. Is that okay? Yes, no. Now, because in higher dimensions, more than one dimension, there are infinitely many directions in which you can take a step. And by the way, in derivative, you choose the step to be as minimum as possible. So with respect to that step, in what direction the output changes a lot. Make sense? There is a step size that defines the derivative, and that step size is as small as possible. But that step you can take that step in any direction if you are more than one way. If you are more than one way. Yes? In what direction you take that step and the change in the output is maximum or minimum?
Make sense? So my question is, what direction has maximum rate of change and what direction has minimum rate of change? Yes? I'll answer this question first and then we'll move towards the actual algorithm and the step size, the optimal step size to do and stuff like that. Clear?
सर्कल में तो बड़ा इजी होगा हमारे लिए डायरेक्शन होता है उसमें सारे से डिस्ट्रिक्ट मतलब लेट्स सपोज 350 को उसमें पॉइंट प्रोवाइड करते हैं उसको हर डायरेक्शन चेक कर लेंगे लेकिन लेट्स सपोज वी विल टॉक अबाउट थ्री डायरेक्शंस ठीक है वो स्फीयर है उसमें हम कैसे रिकवर करेंगे कौन सी डायरेक्शन में जाना है
सो इन द केस ऑफ सर्कल फॉर एग्जांपल इन द केस ऑफ सर्कल द डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग एट एवरी पॉइंट एग्जैक्टली द डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग एट एवरी टेक अ स्टेप इन द नेक्स्ट द डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग In that case, there is the same algorithm will work. We'll just see now. But in machine learning in practice, the surfaces they are roughly smooth. I mean they do not properly change the direction at any point. See? In both of the cases, I will just show that there is a principled way of finding out the direction in which the change happens the most. Make sense? Let me explain how to compute the gradient. Yes? Okay. I am using, let's say this is my function f of two variables x, y. In our case, these two variables will be w0, w1. And then f will be either c or e. C means cost, e means error. Okay. But let me stay in the calculus notation. F of x, y. Normally you write x, comma, y. I'm writing this that this is the vector of variables. You can write them x, comma, y, or you can write an array of variables. Okay? And let's say the answer is, let's say this function is scalar. Scalar means the output is a real number. The output is a real number. Let's say the output is 2x squared minus y squared. Or y to the power. So now you can think of at every point x, comma y, the height of the function is plug in x in this function, plug in that y in this function, and then it returns a real one. That real one is the answer. Yes? And if you see the outputs for every combination of x, comma y, you will see the surface in third dimension. Make sense? Yes, no?
Yes.
Now, to differentiate this with respect to x, the notation is the following. This is derivative of f with respect to x. And when we focus on x, y is treated as constant. And this is 4x. Okay? And the derivative with respect to y, the other variable of the same function, is minus 4y. Okay? And the derivative of this function is just their partial derivatives written in a vector form. Okay? That's a gradient. So let me write the gradient. The symbol is this, gradient of f. That's a vector. Gradient of f, that's a vector. This is basically 4x minus 4y. That's a gradient vector. That's a gradient vector. You can just move gradient vector of any function or variable. So given a function, as long as the function is scalar, scalar means no matter how many variables it takes as input, the output is a real number. Then you can compute the derivative with respect to the first variable. Derivative with respect to the second variable, derivative with respect to the third variable, and so on. Write all these derivatives in a vector form, in a sequence. So whatever your first variable is, the first coordinate of the vector. Whatever your second variable is, the second coordinate of the vector, and so on. That vector of derivatives, partial derivatives, is called gradient vector. And sometimes people do not call it vector, some people call it gradient. Okay? It is handy to call it gradient vector. So, yes? Now, if I want to compute, the gradient or the rate of change in standard x, y, standard x and y of this function at point 1, minus 1, what is the rate of change or the rate, what is the rate vector at x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1? So x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, what's the gradient vector? X is equal to 1, y is equal to 1. So plug in x here, y here, and you get the gradient at, so let me write this as x comma y. So gradient at 1, 1 is simply 4 minus 4. Make sense?
Yes.
4 minus 4. Now, at 1, 1, 1 comma 1, this is the gradient vector. Gradient tells me the rate of change. In 2D, the rate of change has two things. Number 1 and 2D. It's a vector. Number 1, the amount of change. Number 2, in which direction change happens. Make sense? Because it's a vector, there are two quantities associated with this vector. What is the direction of this vector and what is the magnitude of this vector? The magnitude of this vector is basically the change, the amount of change, and the direction is in which direction that change happens. Make sense? So we can conclude the magnitude of this, which is 4 squared plus minus 4 squared. This is a quantity that quantifies the amount of change, and then the direction is simply divide this by its magnitude, and that's the direction in which the change has happened. So that's the direction in which the gradient currently has been computed. Make sense? Yes, no?
Yes.
Now the question is, this is some direction in which gradient has been computed, the direction of the gradient vector. What if I want to compute the rate of change in some other direction? How can I do that? Make sense? Let's say I suggest there is a function, this one. I'm sitting here. I just think that I should move in this way. I should take the tiny possible step, but I will take the step in this direction. Given a particular direction, how can I find out the rate of change in that direction? Make sense? The concept is known as directional derivative. Make sense? Directional derivative. And that number tells me the amount of the change that has happened. And the डायरेक्शन वेक्टर जिस पे मैंने प्रोजेक्शन ली है उस डायरेक्शन में वो चेंज आई मेरी बात समझ आ रही। मिसाल के तौर पर अगर मेरा यू जो है दिस यू शुड आई एरेज़ दिस
Make sense?
नौ If I go away from, so let me explain this in the following way. Let's say I have a vector AB and I have another vector CD and CD is a unit vector. Let's say CD is a unit vector. Your dot product is AC plus B. That's a unit vector. Yes. एक और भी ठीक है इसका होता था वो डायरेक्शन लेके सो आई हैव इफ आई हैव दिस थिंग एफ इफ आई वांट टू टेक द डॉट प्रोडक्ट इन सम डायरेक्शन टू दैट्स अ डायरेक्शन ओके द डॉट प्रोडक्ट इज दिस डायरेक्शन यू डायरेक्शन यही था
कॉस थीटा
And all of the angles between them.
Yes.
Data? Yes. Okay, you have to apply all of them. All of the angles between them.
Yes.
Is that the case?
Yes, sir.
Now, because this is the direction vector. This is the direction vector. Its magnitude is 1. Make sense?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, in which direction this quantity is maximum? Here the cos of the angle is 1.
Zero.
And cos of the angle is 1 when the angle is 0.
Yes.
Which means you are projecting in the same direction.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So the direction of the maximum change is the direction of the gradient. And by the way, when cos of theta becomes minus 1, what is that angle? The direction of the minimum gradient is in any other direction you get in between. So if theta is
any direction or just 90 or 270?
Sorry?
Zero.
So if your direction is 90, your rate of change is 0.
Yes.
If your direction is 180, your rate of change is minus 33.
That's it.
And minus 33 is better than 0 in the sense of minimum. Make sense?
Is
that okay? Yes? No? X axis is way here, y axis is way here. But anyway,
class. Vectors class hai. ये जो वेक्टर्स आप ले रहे हैं यू वेक्टर ये यू वेक्टर कहाँ से है
मैंने कोई डायरेक्शन सोची कि मैं इस डायरेक्शन में ले रही हूँ यानी मैं किसी पर्टिकुलर एक्स कॉमा वाई में था
ठीक है
वहाँ पे फंक्शन की कोई वैल्यू मैं उस एक्स कॉमा वाई से किस डायरेक्शन में मूव करूँ सो दैट द फंक्शन वैल्यू डिक्रीज द मोस्ट सो देयर आर सेवरल डायरेक्शंस आई कैन मूव हियर मूव हियर मूव हियर So at standing at x, y, which in this case is 1, 1, in which direction should I move? Actually, u there are infinity many directions. Now u vector is some direction that I have chosen. If I move this direction, then my pichli value thi f of x, y, or after I have taken the step in this particular direction, now I am at x dash, y dash. What is the difference? So these are infinity many directions. So what direction gives me the minimum change? What direction gives me the faster degrees? That direction happens to be the gradient direction of the object. So there are infinity many directions.
The gradient is with respect to x or separately with respect to x.
Yes.
Separately with respect to
x. Yes, exactly. So gradient, when gradient has been computed, it has been computed in fixing the direction x and freezing the direction y and then freezing the direction x and having the direction make sense? And then there is a result from calculus that if you want to take a particular direction key main derivative, this is the same as you have your gradient and you are orthogonally projecting that. These two are equal. With respect to that, you can establish the direction of the gradient, in that direction, you will get the maximum increase in the function. Because your change will be positive in that direction, and the maximum positive number. So you have f of x, you take the step, now the change is a positive number. F of x plus a positive number, you have a highest increase. In the negative of the gradient, you get the fastest decrease, a negative number. So you have an f of x, comma y, and you move in the negative of the gradient direction, you get a negative number. Okay? And now your new value of the function is smaller than the previous one. And in every other direction, if you could have moved in any other direction, the amount of decrease you got now is the most. I'm not going into again the proof that the orthogonal projection corresponds to the directional vector. There's a proof for this that if let me draw this.
How to compute the gradient in a particular direction.
that is you take the gradient vector that is computed ordinary x variable, y variable, and you take the dot product in whatever direction you want. That gives you the change in that particular direction. We use this vector. And after using this vector, everything is derived. I mean, using this vector, that the change in a particular direction can be computed by the existing gradient vector in xy, and then taking dot product in that direction. Okay? If the change in this particular direction is this, then this is derived that the maximum change will happen in actually the gradient direction, and the minimum is the opposite direction. Now, if you ask me to prove that the direction derivative corresponds to the actual change in that, that is a couple of stuff I'm not going to do. क्योंकि उसके बाद आप ये भी कहेंगे प्रूव द एक्सियम्स ऑफ दैट एंड स्टफ सो दिस इज द बेयर मिनिमम वी आर टेकिंग हाउ टू प्रूव द डायरेक्शन डेरिवेटिव दिस इज द वे आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू प्रूव दैट दिस एक्चुअली गिव्स मी डायरेक्शन डेरिवेटिव देयर इज प्रूफ फॉर दैट देन आफ्टर दैट एवरीथिंग इज डन यस नो सो नाउ वी नो दैट इफ वी मूव ऑपोजिट टू द ग्रेडिएंट डायरेक्शन the function will decrease the most. And why it will decrease the most? You are standing somewhere, let's say, you are standing at this point, in which direction you move, you get, so f of x, y, you are standing somewhere, and you want to move somewhere so that now you see what is the value of the function. If you move in the opposite direction of the gradient, the new point you come in, the height will be smallest of all other heights you could have get with this fixed step you choose. Make sense? It's a little escalating. Aapko agar kaha gaya ki you can take a step of 1 centimeter. You can take a step of 1 centimeter in this direction, that direction, that direction. Now given that you have taken step of 1 centimeter, either smaller or not, larger, in what direction you will dive the most? That is the opposite of the gradient direction.
No.
This is not just for convex functions. This is for the functions where the closed form solution does not exist. You actually want to find out where the gradient is zero, and you move at to that point. You move gradually. Yes, no? Is that okay?
Yes. Yes.
So here is the book. w is not a vector. Okay, w 0, w 1, w 2, tells me so many w's. I'm speaking as some w. I move in this direction. I move in this direction. Clear? I'm sitting here, I move in this direction. But I have to pay loop just like I have to. Or let me take this minus out. So I move in this direction. And I got a new W. My claim is f of f, the function value at mu is smaller or equal to, let me not write equal right now, is smaller than f of. This is the whole. Okay? If I have chosen another direction, if I have chosen another direction, here. Then again I got f of w, but that number may not be that smaller. This is the smallest. Make sense? Is that okay? Yes, no. So main w pe khada hu, ye w hai, isi ke hal pe khada hu. Agar main gradient ke opposite wali direction mein move karu, to jahan main pahunchunga, wahan pe function ki aayegi. That is the smallest of all other choices I could have left. Make sense? So let me, is that, pehli baat ye ki ye isse chok hai. That means that I'm moving some progress. I'm making some progress. Yani main jahan pe khada tha, main ab ek nayi jagah pe aise pe gaya hu ki jo pichli height se kam hai. So I'm moving in a progressively. Main progress kar raha hu. Lekin ye maine minimize करने की direction वो choose की है कि I am minimized for most I could. ठीक है जी? अब ये result कब hold करता है? जब आपने step size उतना ही लिया और जितना step size आपने derivative में choose किया था. Derivative में compute करते रहे, derivative compute करते रहे. जो आपने step लिया था, that step was close to zero. Instantaneous rate of change. Very if you actually deploy that step in the implementation, the amount of time it will take to reach the global minimum is very large. So the heuristic is, it's a rule of thumb, heuristic is, normally, the functions in machine learning you have, the cost functions, they are smooth. And if you get a direction in which the function is changing, the direction will hold for a little time. So take a bigger step rather than a step that is very very small. The very very small step is 0.01. Or even smaller than that. Actually, you cannot feel like zero. The step is limit step times 0. Okay? Take some step to get the algorithm working. But be careful. If you take a large step, then it may be possible that chota step lete to aap decrease hote, bada step lete to you may go. Kyunki har naya step lene ke baad wahan pe jaake dobara decide kare ab kis direction mein step lene, aage jaake phir decide kare ab kis direction mein step lene. Agar aapne step bada le liya to beech mein kuch points aapne skip kar diye jahan pe direction ka tayyur aapne karna tha. Sahi hai? So a bigger step is a problem, a very small step is a problem. So the step size is a critical thing here. Let me write this step size as alpha, and this is known as learning rate. Depending upon whether it is too big or too small, the time your algorithm will take to converge may vary. Clear? And there are good heuristics, there are good rules to choose this parameter. The parameter that works in several cases is this, alpha is choosing this. But there are advanced algorithms that choose this parameter as the relations go on. Make sense? So we will fix this value, alpha being 0.01, that's a fixed step. And then we will say, okay, keep on moving until you find out the w where the gradient becomes 0. Because the w where the gradient becomes 0, that gives you the global minimum if the function was convex, and the function was convex in the case of logistic regression we just saw. So far so good? Now the only in the story, the rest of the story is how to compute the gradient of the logistic regression formulation. And just we will apply that. Gradient descent method. So far?
Yes.
Agar abhi sare same gradient ke andar hai, move on. I'm going towards computing the gradient layers and stuff like that. So far? Remember, abhi jo main thodi der baad f ki jagah pe e likh dunga, that is error, ya c likh dunga, which is the cost, you want to minimize the cost, and rest of the story will stay changed, stay same. Yes, no? You should have known the beginning about the step size, why we have taken the step size in this direction and stuff like that. In the case of convex functions, you will reach the global minimum as you move on. In the case of non-convex functions, you will reach to the nearby local minimum. Yes.
Gradient
of f, that's a relation. It's a vector. जब ये वेक्टर है तो उसकी कोई डायरेक्शन भी है वेक्टर की और उसकी भी डायरेक्शन जब मैं एक वेक्टर कॉलम वेक्टर लिख देता हूं तो ये क्या डायरेक्शन है
तो उसकी मैग्नीट्यूड का नहीं है ना तो भी कॉलम हमने तो खाली उसका डायरेक्शन
मैग्नीट्यूड आपको बता रही है चेंज और डायरेक्शन बता रही है इस डायरेक्शन में इतना चेंज है अगर किसी और डायरेक्शन में जाऊंगा तो वो चेंज कम हो जाएगा
जी आपने अल्फा की वैल्यू ली है इट कुड बी पॉसिबल कि शायद ये ज़्यादा ले
सो दैट्स अ रूल इट इज नॉट आई मीन मे बी इन योर डेटा सेट द वैल्यू डिफरेंट वैल्यू इज द बेस्ट दैट्स व्हाई व्हेन आई से रूल ऑफ थंब और ह्यूरिस्टिक दैट डजंट मीन इट इज द बेस्ट दैट मीन्स इट वर्क्स द मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम सर इफ यू यूज बट इन योर ऑब्वियसली योर डेटा सेट मे बी
यस
बट दैट्स अ फर्स्ट गुड चॉइस लेट्स गो Yes,
इसलिए जो भी लाइन बोली है दोबारा बोलो बोलो ना सही क्या है इसने कहा है ना कि ये जो अल्फा है अगर मैं बहुत थोड़ा लेता हूँ तो हो सकता है कि मेरा जो टाइम है ट्रेन होने में बहुत ज़्यादा लेता और बट इसकी वजह से हो सकता है प्रिसीजन अगर मैं छोटा लिया हुआ तो प्रिसीजन बेहतर होगी लेकिन अगर मैं अल्फा की वैल्यू अपनी बड़ी लूँगा तो इट कुड बी पॉसिबल कि ट्रेन तो जल्दी हो जाए लेकिन उसमें एरर ज़्यादा
नो इनफैक्ट इनफैक्ट ये दोबारा से देखें अल्फा द चॉइस ऑफ अल्फा हैज टू डू विद ओनली द टाइम ऑफ द मर्जर टुगेदर
ओके
व्हेन द व्हेन यू विल रीच टू द पॉइंट वेयर द डेरिवेटिव इज जीरो
अच्छा
द द द द द वैल्यू ऑफ द अल्फा हैज टू डू विद दिस द वैल्यू ऑफ द अल्फा हैज नॉट टू डू विद कि मैं किसी गलत जगह पर पहुंच जाऊंगा और मैं स्टॉप कर
दूंगा
इफ यू टेक अल्फा टू बी वेरी स्मॉल यू मे रीच द ग्लोबल मिनिमम वेरी स्लोली ओके इफ यू टेक द अल्फा टू बी वेरी लार्ज यू मे रीच द ग्लोबल मिनिमम एक्सट्रीमली स्लोली एंड द रीजन इज यू मे टॉप देयर 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 एंड टाइम एंड इफ यू टेक अ वेरी टाइनी स्टेप यू मे एंड इफ यू टेक अ लार्ज स्टेप सो इट इज जस्ट How much time it takes to reach the minimum? Alpha defines that. Alpha does not define I will reach at a point that is wrong. Make sense? So alpha defines time, and this alpha actually is. And there are ways to choose alpha in clever ways to reduce this
time.
Yeah. questions. And I write this by hand because just I want to take this one by hand and jump out. Clear?
Yes.
And that's it.